Hey everyone, hope you guys are doing well. I'm Shubham and you're watching Let Green App. So this is the fourth video of Swift UI, and in this video we will talk about @StateProperty wrapper. And basically @StateProperty is used to update the view whenever there is any change in that specific variable or that state variable. So let's look into the demo first and then we will see how we can create this kind of functionality. So this is the demo which we are going to create in this video, in which we are having one label and one button. So as a user click on this button, it will update this label, and there is a random number is generated and that random number is placed on this label. So whenever there is any change in this label, the whole view will get update. So this is all done via using @StateProperty. So let's look how we can create this thing. So by the end of this video, we are able to use @StateProperty to update the views. And if you want to learn more iOS application development tutorials, so please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon to get the notifications of all my other videos. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit the like button. So let's start the video. And yeah, if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. So let's start the video. Let's create an app. Now you need to open an Xcode and click on single view application and click on next. Just give the name whatever you want to give. I'm just giving state property explained like this, and be sure that user interface should be Swift UI, and click on next and create this project where you want to create, on desktop, on documents, it's totally up to you. So now after creating this project, we will land it on this page, and this is a default UI of Swift UI with the Hello World program or a Hello World view. Now we have to update this thing according to the things which I've seen in the demo. So in demo we are having two things. First is label and second is button. So the label is responsible for updating the things, and button is responsible for calling one function in which the values are set on label. So now let's create one text, and that text is there. Now we have to take one button also. So before taking that button, we have to take a V stack, because in Swift UI all the things are putted or wrapped in a stack. So let's put this thing in a stack. And if you don't have any idea about Swift UI, please subscribe the channel and please follow the complete list of Swift UI tutorials. The link is mentioned in the description as well as on the I button. Now we need to create a button. So simply creating this button, and in this we have to call this method, that is this one, action one. And in the action we have to write the action whatever we want to perform whenever user click on that button. And in this label property we have to pass the things, or in this label closure we have to pass the take value of this button. So like if we want to give a title to this button, like click me, like this thing. And if we will update this thing. So now let's remove this thing, and now let's build this thing again, and I think we will get this thing over here very soon. So this is a live rendering, not right now, but when we click on this button it will be in live rendering. So the text is coming and button is coming with the click me title. So now we need to create one function, and we have to create one property over here. So whenever there changes in that property, it will update the view accordingly. So basically @state is used to update the views whenever there is change in those kind of properties. So let's create one property over here. So where, or we can say that @state where label or count, it's totally up to you. Count like this, and the initial count should be like 0. So whatever is the initial value is 0. Now we have to create one function over here after this view, so that we can update the this count value. So function, we can change the name because count is also already available somewhere in this. So like label count like this. So now let's change this thing and create a function. Now they get random number like this, because we will get a random number from an array. So now let's create one array. So let arr equals to, and in this we have to pass numbers which we will get in return. So we have created an array, and in this we will get a 6 numbers. Now we have to return, we didn't make this as a return type, so let's make a return, and this is of string type. The return is of string type, and in this we have to use arr dot random number, I guess random element. So this will return an optional string, so we need to forcefully typecast this thing, so that, because this is not an optional, So that's why we need to forcefully typecast this thing, because this will return an optional string. Now we need to call this method over the click of that button, and whatever we'll get from this function, we have to assign that thing in this label count. And whenever there is any change in this label count value, this view will automatically update. So now let's call this function. So label count is equals to get random number. So we will call this method, and I think we need to put this thing as a self. Yeah, self, because they are. Now let's build this thing and check that it is working fine or not. So let's run this project and see is it working or not. So by doing this thing, we will able to update the views whenever there is any change in that state property. So we will take every property as a state if we are updating that properties, and on that updation we need to update the view also. So we have to take those properties as a state type. Okay, we have one issue, like we didn't put the value over here, so we have to put a label value over here. Label count. Yeah, now let's run this thing and again and check that it is working fine or not. So it's running and zero is printed. Now click on this thing, and as we are clicking on this thing, it will generating a random number from 1 to 6 which we have assigned over here. Now let's create some more thing, like just updating these things, plus we have to some design. So for designing, let's move over here, and for designing we have to first design this text. So let's design this text, and the first thing which we'll want to that frame, because it's very coming in center. So let's give some width. So UI screen dot main dot bounce dot width, like this. And if we want to provide a height, we can provide a height like 40 pixels, and we don't want any kind of alignment. So it's like this thing. And now let's change the color. So for changing the color, we want a background color. So dot background color, and it's like color. This one dot red. It's totally up to you. You can take any other color. And for text color, we need to use a foreground color. And in this, we have to use dot white. I guess white. Now let's run this thing and check it is working fine or not. We can also resume this thing to see the things over here. So it's running and its height is also increased, and the text color is in white, but there is no spacing between these two things. So for that, we have to give a spacing to this this V stack. And if you don't know about any stacks, please go and watch out the stack video also. That is also very important part of Swift UI to know understanding a basic concept how stacks work. So for that, please go and watch out the video. Now we have given a spacing to this V stack, and as we see that whenever we give a spacing, it will automatically update over here. Now let's change the color of this click me button. So just, or we can say that roll the dice. So we will get a number from 1 to 6 and it's kind of a dice. So now let's update this thing dot font. So let's get some bold font dot title, like this. Now let's change the color dot foreground color, and in this we have to pass like let's get what are the different colors, black, blue, gray, green, orange, this one. Now let's run. So now let's roll this dice and we will update the things automatically. So this is how we can use the state property to update the views and the functionalities. So Swift come up with various kind of these property wrappers, just like at state, at the rate binding, environmental object, and all the different kind of property wrappers to perform these kind of functionalities. We will definitely see all these things in the upcoming videos. So if you are new to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button. And if you learned something from this video, please like this video. And if you have any query or suggestion, please post that thing in the comment box. I'll shortly answer on that query, and meet you in the next video. Thank you.